10 years passed since Christopher Robin and Sophia encountered Pooh and his friends in the forest last time. Owl, Tigger, and Rabbit was forced to drag Pooh's body back to their home. They had this special honey that could bring creatures back to life, and now Pooh was back, better than ever. Owl was raging angry and wanted to kill everything so bad. Pooh and Christopher, though, faced the same problems. Robin was accused of being a liar and a crybaby. And Pooh was being shouted at by his friends for being a stupid bear who can do nothing right. And now, Rabbit started to get angry. He saw that this trio could do nothing right and lets everyone escape. He wanted to take over now. And of course, the trio let Rabbit try. And now, they're back for the hunt of Robin yet again.
So, Robin, tell me again about these creatures. What do they want from you?
As I said, nothing but pain. They want me dead, and they're probably still out there searching for me.
Has it ever bothered you that maybe these creatures never existed?
Well, I know that they were there.
Robin, listen to me. A yellow big bear, a bouncy angry tiger, a demonic owl, and a psycho bunny? That does not sound realistic, does it?
Both me and Sophia saw them with my own naked eyes.
How is Sophia doing, by the way? Do you two still live together? Didn't you even get married? Even slightly heard that you've got a kid?
Yeah, we got Alex. 9 years. But, well, Sophia divorced me, so we're not living together anymore.
And why's that?
Well, she says I need to stop talking about my friends. Let the story scare Alex.
There's your answer, Alex. Please, you need to try and move on.
Christopher Robin started reflecting on life and decided to kill his wife and kid.
What the fuck? No! What's wrong with you?
It was just a joke, sorry. Well, for the group of friends, they were also getting troubles.
Pooh, Owl, and Tigger, the first problem we have encountered is the big mistake made by Robin. He killed Piglet and Eeyore. We just did what we had to do. We just did what we had to survive. That's nothing we can change.
Yes, obviously. But what does this help our case?
Well, I've heard some very, very great news lately. Chris got divorced by Sophia. And they got a kid. He still loves her. What if we send Pooh and Tigger to Chris? Just to scare the shit out of him with warnings about Sophia and their son, and telling him that we're gonna kill them. That would probably make him angry.
Okay? Is that everything? Why don't we just take this prosthetic life there and then?
Because we can't end his suffering yet. He needs to feel the same pain that we felt all these years.
I hope you intend on killing his family for real anyways!
Yeah. What's the fun in just... See?
Of course. They're gone as well. Nothing will stand in our way when that's done. We'll just have to wait for the perfect moment.
Yeah. An owl and you kill the fam?
I guess.
Exactly. Now, let's show them our feelingless bodies when we have nothing left in our minds than revenge.
But what happens when Christopher and his loved ones are gone? What will we do then?
Well then, we'll...
Yeah, what happens after?
Haven't you gotten that far?
During their conversation, Christopher drove to Sophia's house. She opened the door and almost closed it again in his face.
Please, I just want to see our child.
You're sick, Christopher. Come back when you have been changed.
I just want to see Alex. Please, don't be heartless.
Okay, but you can't stay here for too long.
Sophia and Chris got into a hateful conversation while he was there, and that's the one following up.
Sophia, I know things have been rough, but I need you to believe me. Those creatures are real, and they're after us again.
Christopher, this obsession of yours is tearing you apart. It's why we're not together anymore. It's why Alex is scared of you. You need to let it go.
You think I haven't tried? But every night I see them. I hear them. I know they're coming for us.
I can't do this again. Alex needs stability. He needs safety.
As Sophia spoke, a shadowy figure watched from the edge of the forest. It was Pooh, his eyes glowing with a sinister light. He could see the tension between Christopher and Sophia, and it brought a twisted smile to his face.
Just a little more, Christopher. Just a little more, and you'll break.
Back in the house, the argument between Christopher and Sophia continued to escalate.
Sophia, you have to listen to me. They're coming. They want to hurt Alex. They want to hurt you.
Enough! I won't let you scare Alex anymore. You need help, Christopher. Real help. Maybe then we can talk about you being a part of Alex's life again.
Just as Sophia was about to close the door on Christopher, Alex appeared at the top of the stairs, clutching a small stuffed bear.
Mother, is Father gonna stay with us?
No, sweetheart. Daddy just came to visit for a little while.
Alex, buddy, I love you. You know that, right?
I know, Father, but why are you sobbing?
Before Christopher could respond, a loud crash came from outside. Sophia rushed to the window, her face paling as she saw a familiar figure in the yard.
Christopher, it's Pooh. He's here.
The shadowy figure of Pooh stood in the yard, his eyes locked onto the house, a malevolent grin spreading across his face. From behind him, Tigger and Rabbit emerged, their expressions equally twisted with malice.
It's happening, Sophia. Take Alex and run. Now!
What about you?
I'll hold them off. Just go!
Sophia grabbed Alex and ran towards the back door, but before she could reach it, the door burst open, and Tigger lunged inside, his eyes wild with fury.
Where do you think you're going? The fun's just starting.
Christopher tackled Tigger, trying to buy some time for Sophia and Alex to escape. As they struggled, Rabbit and Owl appeared, blocking the exit. As Christopher fought desperately, Sophia managed to slip past Rabbit and Owl, running into the dense forest with Alex in her arms. Pooh watched them go, a dark satisfaction in his eyes.
Run, Sophia! Run, Alex! We'll find you soon enough!
Back in the house, Christopher was losing his battle against Tigger. With a final powerful blow, Tigger knocked Christopher unconscious, leaving him sprawled on the floor.
What now, Pooh? What do we do now?
We'll let him live. For now. The real fun begins when he wakes up and realizes his family is gone.
As the twisted creatures left Christopher lying on the floor, a chilling silence fell over the house. Outside, Sofia and Alex continued to run, unaware of the horror still to come. The hunt was far from over, and the forest would soon echo with their screams.
Mother, what is this situation we are in? Why are we currently sprinting through this forest?
No worries, honey. We're just taking a trip.
Why is that stridiform, or as some may call an owl, currently chasing us?
We are playing a dangerous catch game. Just stick on!
1 hour later, Chris wakes up. It has started to get dark outside, and he sees Pooh and Tigger's shadow in the room. Pooh is sitting in Sophia's big cozy chair, and Tigger crawls around on all fours in the complete darkness. He stands up, ready to confront them.
What do you want from me?
Oh, Christopher. It's not about what we want from you. It's about what we want to do to you and your family.
This is just the beginning, Christopher. The fun's just starting.
Christopher clenched his fists, trying to suppress the terror rising in his chest. He needed to find Sophia and Alex before it was too late.
You won't hurt them. I'll stop you.
Oh, Christopher, haven't you realized yet? This isn't a game you can win.
Meanwhile, Sophia and Alex were deep in the forest, struggling to navigate through the dense underbrush. Sophia's heart pounded as she tried to keep Alex calm.
Alex, we need to keep moving. We can't let them catch us.
I am quite shaken up right now, Mother. What if they locate us?
They won't, sweetheart. We just have to stay together and stay quiet.
Back at the house, Christopher faced down Pooh and Tigger, his determination unwavering despite the odds.
If you want me, come and get me. Leave them out of this.
Brave words, Christopher. Let's see how brave you really are.
In a sudden, ferocious attack, Tigger lunged at Christopher. But this time, Christopher was ready. He dodged the initial strike and grabbed a heavy lamp from a nearby table, swinging it with all his might. The lamp connected with Tigger's head, sending him sprawling to the ground.
Impressive, Christopher. But you can't stop us all.
With a menacing growl, Pooh advanced on Christopher, but before he could reach him, a new figure appeared in the doorway. It was Sophia, holding a large kitchen knife, her eyes blazing with determination.
Stay away from him!
Pooh hesitated, caught off guard by Sophia's unexpected return. Using the distraction, Christopher charged at Pooh, tackling him to the ground. Sophia rushed to Christopher's side, and together they struggled to subdue the monstrous bear.
We need to get out of here. Now!
Go find Alex. I'll hold them off.
You can't keep this up forever, Christopher. We'll find you. We'll find them all.
Sophia nodded, her grip tightening on the knife. She ran back to the forest, her mind racing with thoughts of how to protect her son. Christopher, meanwhile, fought with all his strength to keep Pooh pinned down. Christopher's determination only grew stronger. He knew that the only way to protect his family was to end this nightmare once and for all. With a final desperate effort, he struck Pooh's head against the floor, rendering the bear unconscious.
This isn't over. Not by a long shot.
Sophia found Rabbit standing in front of her in the dark forest.
Nice to finally meet you, Sophia. I've heard so much about you. I never got a chance to join our last encounter.
Where is Alex?
He is somewhere. Owl is having fun, if you say so.
Sophia threw the kitchen knife into Rabbit's shoulder. A loud screaming noise could be heard from the rabbit. The hit with the knife made Rabbit realize the pain, the agonizing pain left after hurting someone. He nearly turned back to good, but remembered the pain Robin left him with after he left for college.
Hello, Alex. Having fun?
Identify yourself at this moment, sir. What have you done to my mother?
She's dead.
Oh, am I? Really?
She said from behind him.
Impossible! How did you...
Sophia lunged at Owl with a renewed ferocity, the kitchen knife still clutched in her hand. Owl flapped his wings in a frantic attempt to fend her off, but Sophia was relentless, her only thought to protect Alex.
Run, Alex! Run to Daddy!
Alex hesitated for a split second before sprinting through the forest, his small legs carrying him as fast as they could. Sophia continued to struggle with Owl, slashing and stabbing, driven by a mother's desperate instinct. Sophia's strength was waning, but she managed to land one final blow, sending Owl reeling back. She took the moment to break free and dashed after Alex, her heart pounding in her chest. Meanwhile, back at the house, Christopher dragged the unconscious Pooh to a corner, tying him up with whatever he could find. He knew it was only a matter of time before the others returned, and he needed to be ready.
Stay strong, Sophia. Find Alex. Keep him safe.
As Christopher finished securing Pooh, Tigger began to stir, groaning as he regained consciousness. Christopher readied himself, his eyes never leaving Tigger.
Safe.
You're making a big mistake, Christopher. We won't stop until we get what we want.
And I won't stop until my family is safe.
Alex ran into the house, ready to jump into Chris's arms, when suddenly Tigger lifted him up in the air, throwing him into a corner.
No, you big chunk of disturbed, monstrous being!
Chris began running up to Tigger to blow him out, when Pooh broke free and lifted Chris up, holding him tight from behind.
Do it!
Pooh said and looked at Tigger.
You'll get to watch a bloody show now, Christopher! Watch how everything will be taken away from you, just as it was taken away from me.
As Tigger drove closer to Alex, Rabbit were seen halting into the room, bleeding from his shoulders.
Wow, the show about to happen.
Please, Rabbit. I know there's good in you. He is a child. You can't let them kill an innocent child.
I'm sorry, Christopher, but you left us to die all alone. We will let you watch that happen to your family.
Rabbit, I love you. I love you all. I've always loved you. Please, show that you have some emotions left. A child, Rabbit. A child.
The feeling that went into Rabbit earlier came back for a brief of a moment. Now the situation got colder and more intense. What would happen next? Rabbit looked at Tigger walking slowly closer to Alex, ready to strike. He also looked at Pooh. Pooh glanced at the same eyes as Rabbit. Pooh was feeling it too, but Pooh didn't do anything about it. Rabbit looked back at Tigger and Alex. Pooh also saw this and maybe something was wrong, but he had no intention to intervene. He stayed loyal to Tigger and Owl. But Tigger, he was still filled with rage, evil, anger, and much, much more. He was the most violent of them all. And then it happened. Tigger raised his clawed paw, ready to deliver the fatal blow to Alex. Time seemed to slow down as Christopher, trapped in Pooh's iron grip, watched in helpless horror. But in that tense moment, something unexpected happened.
Stop!
Rabbit's voice, filled with a mix of desperation and remorse, echoed through the room. Tigger hesitated, his paw still raised as everyone turned back to look at Rabbit.
What are you doing, Rabbit? This is what we planned!
No, Tigger. This isn't right. Christopher's right. He's always been right. We're better than this.
Tigger's eyes blazed with fury, but a flicker of uncertainty passed through them. Rabbit's words seemed to reach something deep inside him, a long-buried memory of the happier times they once shared.
Weak Rabbit! You've always been...
Tigger, I'm strong enough to see that this isn't the way. We need to stop.
Pooh's grip on Christopher loosened slightly as he watched the scene unfold, the conflict clear in his eyes. Sofia, still clutching her knife, slipped into the room behind Rabbit, her eyes darting between her son and the twisted creatures. Alex, shaking with fear, scrambled to his feet and ran to Sofia, clutching her tightly. With Alex safe, Sofia's determination to protect her family only grew stronger.
Pooh, listen to Rabbit. This isn't who you are.
Christopher?
Pooh's eyes met Christopher's, and for a moment, the darkness seemed to fade. Pooh released Christopher, stepping back with a look of confusion and sorrow. Tigger's rage exploded. He lunged at Rabbit, claws outstretched. But Rabbit, finally finding his courage, stood his ground. In a swift motion, Rabbit pulled the knife from his shoulder and plunged it into Tigger's chest.
You betrayed me.
I'm sorry, Tigger. I'm so sorry.
Tigger collapsed to the ground, his eyes wide with shock. Rabbit, tears streaming down his face, dropped the knife and fell to his knees beside his fallen friend. The room fell into a heavy silence. Christopher, Sophia, and Alex looked at the scene with a mix of relief and sorrow. Pooh stood motionless, his expression a mix of regret and pain.
What have we done?
We can still make things right, Pooh. We can find a way to move past this.
Christopher approached Pooh cautiously, extending a hand. Pooh looked at Christopher's outstretched hand, the weight of their shared past heavy in his eyes. He reached out, grasping Christopher's hand firmly.
Let's end this madness.
But just as the light seemed to shine yet again, the biggest fear was realized. Tigger jumped up and attacked Rabbit. He scratched Rabbit's throat slightly, and Rabbit looked deep into Tigger's eyes.
Traitor. Even if the fight's over, does not mean that the war is...
No!
Christopher flew at Tigger, boxing him, punch after punch after punch after punch. Blood started sipping out of Tigger's nose. And the story has gotten too dark, so we need to lighten it up. When out of the blue, Rabbit's hand grabbed Chris's hand, stopping him.
Robin, this is not who we are. You just taught me that. Don't be like him.
Chris, still filled with anger, started to calm down. Rabbit fell back to the ground, but in his last moments, he managed to utter his final words before seeing the light.
Protect your family. Find peace.
I promise, Rabbit, I won't let this madness continue.
We've all lost our way, but... Maybe there's still a chance for us.
With those final words, Rabbit's eyes closed and he lay still. The room was filled with a profound silence, the weight of their collective actions sinking in. Christopher, tears streaming down his face, looked at the others with a renewed sense of determination. Sophia and Alex clung to each other, their eyes wide with a mixture of fear and hope. Pooh, standing in the center of the room, seemed lost in thought, his expression a mix of sorrow and reflection. Tigger, now weakened and subdued, sat against the wall, his eyes filled with a smoldering rage. Despite his injuries, his spirit seemed unbroken, a dangerous glint in his eyes.
This is over, Christopher. This is far from over.
No, Tigger. It's not over. But it's time we stopped fighting and started healing. For all of us.
Christopher took a deep breath, gathering his resolve. He knew that Tigger was right. The path to redemption and safety was long and treacherous. But with his family by his side, he felt a glimmer of hope. As the night deepened, Christopher, Sophia, Alex, and Pooh began to make plans to move forward. They knew that the darkness still lingered, but they were determined to face it together.
Well, we can't leave Tigger sitting here in the dark forever. He is all lost. There's no way in turning him back. But we might have a place to put him, to the day he dies.
Yeah, I know exactly where you mean.
That's when Owl raged into the room. He flew fastly over to Tigger, lifted him up, and flew to the door. He stopped in his tracks, though, turned to Robin, Sophia, Alex, and Pooh, and muttered his last words of the episode. They were dark and left the group shocked. Before he flew away with Tigger, away to their underground camp, and that was the last we saw of them for this episode. Owl's last words were,
"You think this is the end? You can't kill what you've created, Christopher. We'll always be a part of you, and we will return."
With those haunting words, Owl and Tigger disappeared into the night, leaving the broken remnants of their once innocent world behind. Christopher, Sophia, Alex, and Pooh stood in the silence, the weight of their actions and the promise of future battles heavy in the air.
It's over for now. But we need to be ready. They will come back.
And when they do, we'll face them together.
The family gathered their belongings and left the house, moving away from the haunting memories that lingered there. As they walked, Christopher held Sophia and Alex close, a newfound resolve in his heart. Weeks passed, and the wounds, both physical and emotional, began to heal. Christopher and Sophia decided to move to a new town, hoping for a fresh start. Pooh, choosing to stay with them, became a comforting presence for Alex, who slowly began to feel safe again. As time went on, the nightmares became less frequent, and the laughter returned to their home. Christopher, though always vigilant, found solace in the love of his family and the strength they showed in the face of darkness. One evening, as the sun set and the shadows lengthened, Christopher sat on the porch, watching Alex play in the yard. Pooh sat beside him, both of them lost in their thoughts.
Do you think they'll ever really come back?
I don't know, Christopher, but I do know that we'll be ready if they do.
Christopher nodded, feeling a sense of peace he hadn't felt in years. The future was uncertain, but he knew that as long as they stood together, they could face anything. And so, with the darkness held at bay, Christopher, Sophia, Alex, and Pooh continued to build a new life. The past might never be fully forgotten, but the bonds of love and courage would always shine through the shadows. As the camera panned away from the peaceful scene, the forest remained ominously quiet, holding its secrets and whispers of past horrors. But for now, there was hope, and that was enough. And that concludes this episode of Creepypasta Radio. Stay tuned for more tales of terror and survival. Until next time, sleep well, if you can.